This is Postman. This is how it looks. This is how the tabs look. If you want to close all the tabs, it's fine. Okay. So let's start from the scratch. Let's start from a new request collection environment. Let's start making a new collection. Okay, so collection, you can just assume it as a new folder in your system. Okay, so let's have this a test collection. A test collection basically will have all the requests. So this is a folder basically. Now you can share this folder with your team. So imagine this as a folder which you want to share in some near future with your team. Okay, so you have to make this in such a way that they understand it in the simplest way. Okay, for example, I made an API which logins a user. So I'll name this API as login. I won't name it something like slash login slash API auth or something like this. I won't do that. I will always make sure if I'm making a CRUD operation, I will make sure that this is create, update, delete and everything. I'll make sure that I'm name these APIs properly. So let's name or let's start naming these APIs. Let's start adding a request. Okay, so the request name, let's take it demo API. So demo API, which I'm giving a demo for. Okay, demo API. What is the description of this API? So this is basically for a demo purpose.
Shubham, sorry to interrupt. So what are we requesting here for?
So basically this is an API. If you just imagine a server who is always ready to give you something or give you their services. Let's say my server of AHC, which we are making right now, it can give you login authentication. It can give you login access. It can give you all the topics or all the categories or videos, whatever you want. But how to know that what are we requesting for or what are we aiming for? So for that, we have to have a clear picture. For example, if you want to make a login API, it should go in AHC folder. It should be named as login and it should be redirected to or the URL should be right. So all this framework is provided by Postman. All the framework is provided by Postman. So in this demo, I'm just giving you how to save a request to my folder. So what is a request? Request is basically an API. So I'll just save it to test collection. So my demo API is ready. It's currently blank. I don't have anything here. Now it's the responsibility of the person who is creating the API to make this entire form, so that everyone can access it in the simplest way possible. So I want to test this API. For that, I have these tabs which I need to keep in mind. What are the settings for this API? Do I want to enable a certificate? So you don't have to go into this deep that what are the settings. You don't want to do any changes to settings. These are the test cases which you want to write. So you are not a tester, so don't have to worry about that. Pre-request script, you don't have to worry about this as well. You need to worry about body. Okay, so what all things are you passing? For example, if you are creating an API which says that create a user, so in that case maybe you need a form like a username value Shubham. Similarly, you might have an image of that user. So in that you can write image or profile picture, and in here you will be confused that how can I write an image? How can I write an image? But you have this option that if you have text or you can have file as well. So let's say you can select a file as well. So you can select files from here. Okay. So this way Postman gives you all possible combinations and all possibilities to test APIs, even production level APIs, all kinds of APIs you can test using Postman. So let's ignore this image part. So this is the demo for body. Mostly you have to focus on raw part. Okay, so raw part is basically the body where we have to send the JSON body, something like this. You have to send the JSON body. Okay, PIN, password, anything which you have to send, something like that. But currently what API which we are testing is just one get API. Okay, this is the API which we are testing, demo purpose. And let's see what all this API requires. This API has query parameters. Okay, so these are the query parameters. So API has these query parameters, which is page is equal to 2, which means it uses pagination. So pagination is one concept which is really amazing. So whenever you have to show more than 10 records or let's say 100 records, you don't fit all those 100 records on one page. You paginate it. So this API supports pagination. So let's see. All you have to do is just send, and it will send you a response. So this response is basically prettified. So you can see it is all structured. Similarly, you can show the raw response. Your browsers basically show the raw response. So you can change all these things. So this is how your browser visualizes. So this is how you get a response from an API. So let's say you have per page is equal to 6. So there is one key which says that per page is equal to 6. You can add this key here in params. So per page, you don't want 6 items, you want 2 items. So you just have to pass 2 and send. So it will just give you 2 items, okay, and one add or something like that. So it will give you 2 items. So this way you can play around with APIs using Postman. In case we had to add some data to some server, so just have to do this. Instead of get, you just have to use post. If you want to update some data, you can use put. If you want to delete some data, you can use delete. Similarly, you have to make all these APIs. So if you see our collection AHC, so AHC has all these APIs, and I make sure that all these APIs work. So it's my responsibility to make all these APIs and then add these APIs and even give the headers, the body, whichever is required, so that you guys can understand. But in coming future, whenever you will get the task to create these APIs, it will be your responsibility that you can't say that I have made an API which does this, or it takes an argument of username and password, you can test it out. You should not do something like that. Instead, what you can do is, I have made an API, I have added it to Postman, it is a post API, it has this, it has no headers, it has body, and you can easily access that API if I share this folder with you. Let's say I shared this folder, I share it publicly, I can share it publicly as well. If I just update this link and I copy it, I'll share it to your chat. So this way I can share my API's collection. I can share all the folders, whichever I have. This is how we coordinate with UI developers or web developers. So whenever someone creates an API, they just add it to a folder. Okay. So this collection, they just add it to the collection, and you saw how to add this. Let's do it once again. All you have to do is click on this. Add a new request, make a new request, test request 2, again save to collection, this is your test request 2, and you create your API, anything, Horizon, anything, your API, you just check if it works or not. If it works, well and good. As soon as you see that it is working right, you just save as or save to your collection. And whenever you see that it is saved, you just have to share it with your co-developers or with your team. Okay. So this was a basic overview of what we have to do with Postman. Postman is really big software. If you can see the play button, if I just click on play button and I give this run command, one by one, all these APIs will be tested. One by one, all these APIs will be tested, and it can give me a report as well that this API was failing, this API passed successfully, this API didn't give me any response. It will tell me everything. But your main motive is to make it in such a way that your team understands it. Okay, And how do your team understand it? Again, I have told you how to make an API, how to make a collection. Okay. So any doubts related to these tabs? I have explained these tabs. So params is basically query params, which you always write in your get request. For example, if your API is this localhost get SMS or something like this. If you want to add a query parameter, so query parameters always come in your URL. So I have to add a query parameter, name is equal to Shubham. So it comes directly in your URL section. Okay, it comes directly to your URL section. If I want to add,
it requires the server to start.
Exactly. So just assume for now that my server is always running. Okay. Just assume for now that my server is running. For example, this login API. Just assume that this localhost server is running. Okay, just assume for now that this server is running. This framework is already made for you. In future, you will have to make this. That's why I had to explain what is raw, what is none, and what is body, what is query parameter. So in future, you will have to do this. But for now, all you have to do is take this collection from me, import it to your Postman, set up the server on your local machine, and just give this send command. Now I got one valid response. Okay, I'll just share this collection with you again. I'll share this with you, and all you have to do is to go here, import and link. You just have to paste that link and continue. So you can see name AHC, it will ask import. Yes, import. So our collection AHC already exists. So this is how you import collections. Okay. This can be a JSON file also. For example, if I want to export, and I export it, this will be a JSON file. Okay. So I'll save it as JSON. Okay. And I can share the JSON as well. Okay. And I can even share the link as well. For example, I am sharing a collection. I can share it as a link as well, public link. So whoever has an access to this link can basically import this collection. So it's good to share these links only in our private domain. And if you have JSON, so it's good to always upload JSON on GitHub or GitLab or whichever is your storage repo. So what we do at the end of the day, whenever we create APIs, we just make those APIs or test these APIs using Postman. We save them in a collection. We export the collection. We export the collection, and the JSON which is exported, we just commit it to our dev branch or master branch or GitLab. So we just do this part so that whoever wants to, you know, access these APIs or understand how these APIs are working, they can basically have a look. In future, whenever you will be making APIs or something like that, just make sure that everyone understands what this URL is or what is the request type. So this is the request type. There are these types of requests. We basically work with four types of requests. If you can see, post, get, delete, and put. So these are the four requests which are used in this project. Front-end developer ya fir jiske saath bhi main kaam kar raha hu, he doesn't know that what is the key. What is the key name and what all are the arguments which are passed. He doesn't know. He doesn't know what is the header which is passed. So my job is to make a Postman collection in such a way that it has all these headers and all these keys passed, and I'll make sure that it's working. And when I make sure that it is working, I'll save it and I'll share this collection with him so that he can get to know what name keys are used in this API, and he doesn't have to worry about anything. He just have to directly just check all these keys, and accordingly he'll have to change it in his code. So this is basically the use of Postman, so that even every team can collaborate and know what keys are required or what URL is required. For example, no one knows what is the URL for getting all the categories or getting all the topics. No one knows. But see, I have mentioned it here and I have saved it. So using this, Ashok can get to know that, okay, invalid page, something like this. Using this, Ashok can know how to, you know, how, where to find these categories. So let's say if I had made this wrong, if I had made something like this, and if I tried to send this, so I'll get him an error. So my job here is to give something to the team which doesn't give me any errors, and it is quite perfectly in working condition, then only I will share this with my team, so that they don't have to worry about anything. They just have to look at these things. Okay, they have to do this sending. Okay, chal raha hai. Now they can use all this in their web application or Android application as it is they want.